Buongiorno ragazzi, welcome back into the kitchen. Chef Peppino here at your service. Today I have a treat for you. We're gonna make together melanzane alla parmigiana, eggplant parmigian. It's right. I never met nobody who didn't love this recipe. It's a favorite comfort food meal for Italians and non-Italians alike. It's one of my favorite recipes from childhood. My mother always made it for us. It's a nice, warm, comfort food, creamy eggplant, warm pomodoro sauce, melted gooey cheese. It really is an Oscar award-winning production in the mouth. We're gonna make a healthier version. We're not gonna fry, we're gonna bake it by roasting the eggplant so we can really pull out the moisture and intensify all of that wonderful, natural, interesting, unique flavor of the eggplant. We're gonna bring that to the forefront. Today we're also gonna make homemade breadcrumbs that will give you a crunchy element to any savory dish you choose to put it on. Eggplant is a very beautiful, very unique vegetable. We wonder, where does it come from? How did it originate? Long time ago, back in India, there is a little egg and it came across a very beautiful plant. Excuse me, signora, would you maybe like to attend the egg dance with me?
Well, I don't know. My parents said don't talk to strange eggs. But, you know, I don't always listen to them. Yeah, okay, so maybe.
E voilà, about 9 months later, we have eggplant. Allora, cuciniamo. This is gonna be good. Starting with 3 medium eggplants. The smaller you can get the eggplants, the better. That means fewer seeds and less bitterness. We're gonna cube this eggplant up into roughly 1-inch cubes. And if there's extra seeds, just cut those seeds out. Then you're gonna put your eggplants into a couple of bowls or colanders, throwing a couple of teaspoons of salt, get in there with your hands, evenly coated, and we're gonna forget about it for 1 hour. What we want to do is drain all of that bitter liquid that naturally exists inside the eggplant. You're gonna have about half the amount of cooked eggplant than you do raw eggplant. Now we're gonna get started on the breadcrumbs. Start with a stale loaf of bread that you have around the house. Any bread will do. Our goal here is to cube the bread into about 2-3 centimeters, 1 inch. We can increase the surface area, which means more crispiness and more beautiful flavor. Throw the bread onto a couple of baking sheets, give it a nice drizzle of olive oil, some kosher salt, some peperoncino, and I have here Herbe de Provence, which is a mix of thyme, oregano, sage, rosemary, marjoram. If you just have oregano or pepper, that will also do, but I really like to spice these up and make them very fragrant and herbaceous. Throw them in the oven for about 10 minutes. Make sure they do not burn. After they come out, they're gonna be beautiful, golden brown and crispy. I like to throw it into a bag and use either wine bottle, but I realize alcohol makes me not feel too good, so I use rolling pin to just roll the heck out of these breadcrumbs, break them up to a size that I like, a consistency that I like. Not breaking every bit. I like to leave some chunks so the mouth can have fun too, you know. Breadcrumbs in Italian, briciole di pane. And moving over to the sink now, we're gonna drain the eggplant. And I just wanted to show you that brown, bitter liquid that comes out after an hour letting it sit. Now you're gonna really have to hunker down, put your sweatpants on, and squeeze the heck out of this eggplant. Think of something that you really don't like, you're upset about, and then you just use all those hand muscles, squeeze all that bitter liquid out of the eggplant. This is really how Peppino works out. We see the eggplant has shrunk in size. If there's a little bit too much salt you see on the eggplant, give it a rinse and then squeeze them out again. Now we start to see this new wonderful greenish color in the eggplant. After that, I'm throwing all the eggplant in a bowl, drizzling a couple of tablespoons of olive oil, coating them evenly, transferring to a roasting pan with some parchment paper, throwing them in the oven for about 30 minutes at 400 degrees. After they come out, they're gonna be lovely, shrunken, intensified in flavor, and a beautiful dark color. Now we need a lovely sauce to go along with the melanzane e la parmigiana. So into the pan I have a tablespoon of olive oil, some garlic, some peperoncino, just extracting some of the flavor, and then I go in with all of my passata. In the passata, a little bit of basil, salt, and I also want to add to this a lot of dried oregano from the garden. If you can get fresh dried oregano, really is more flavorful, more aromatic, and changes your life really. And we're gonna let this simmer for a few minutes until it reduces around the spoon along the bottom of the pan until it leaves a line, and that's good enough for me.
Questa è la nostra bellissima salsa di pomodoro. Steamy, warm, tomatoey, basil, oregano.
The only smell you need to fill the kitchen and to fill your nostrils.
Now grating about 1.5 cups of beautiful mozzarella. Now we know the inspiration for the hair. All of those Renaissance paintings of angels.
Now we're going to assemble everything together into a bowl. You have your roasted eggplant.
Add about 3/4 of the sauce to that.
The leftover sauce will be put on top and just for scarpetta, because who doesn't want to have a piece of bread and some sauce beside them at dinner time? Throwing in all together the cheese. I have also about 1 cup of Parmigiano Reggiano cheese. It's best to use a dry salted aged cheese like Parmigiano Reggiano. And all of this process, baking the eggplant, mixing it together with the sauce and the cheese, you can do this up to a day in advance. In fact, the flavors will marry even more. So if you have the time, do it the day before, plan ahead, and your dish will be that much more spectacular tasting.
We're then gonna add all of the mixture into your roasting dish. And we're gonna add a little bit more cheese on top just to cover it, and we're gonna caramelize this cheese, make it bubbly, gooey, add another layer of flavor, throw it in the oven for 30 to 40 minutes.
Ragazzi, what a cooking journey, what an adventure, miraculous, marvelous. We're just going to let this puppy sit for a couple of minutes because the flavors are quite excited still and they have to calm down. Our melanzane alla parmigiana has rested. So what are we waiting for? Let's taste. Let me get a piece with some of this caramelized crusty cheese. E bella. Wow, wow, wow. I mean, it does not get better than that. Creamy, luxurious eggplant. The aroma is so warm, so familiar. I can taste the basil, the oregano, the garlic, the olive oil, the peperoncino, they all stayed together in the oven, in the pan, got to know each other, became the best of friends, and now they have reached flavor salvation. For us, it's amazing and it's a gift. We have to thank them, we have to pay homage to them and respect their flavor, respect their integrity of the ingredient. That's all from the smell, I didn't even taste yet. So we're gonna put a little bit of breadcrumb, gonna give us a nice crunch, a little bit more Parmigiano Reggiano. I'm gonna show you. Take a look at that, huh? I think you are wise enough to know how much flavor has just sunk in to the eggplant, treating it with patience, letting it cook, letting it become creamy and luxurious. I just need a little bit more olive oil on top for that peppery note. Some of the breadcrumb. I'm sorry, I'm salivating way too much. I'm like a Saint Bernard. Warm, picante, a little bit spicy. I like it that way. Herbaceous, peppery, tomato sauce with the eggplant, with the melanzane. Texture, look at, I can't really speak too much. It's just perfect. Memories, flavors, warmth. The texture is in my mouth. It's incredible. We have sweet caramelized cheese, creamy, cremoso, unctuous, untuoso, silky eggplant. It got so lovely and soft, but still has a little bit of a texture. But even if it didn't, we have the help coming from the breadcrumbs. So crunchy, così croccante, salt from the cheese, and the lovely peppery fresh olive oil is everything your mouth wants and needs. Really, not enough words to describe how much I love this dish and how good it is. I know you're gonna love it too. If you haven't made it. You're gonna really appreciate the flavor of the eggplant once we remove that bitter liquid, which took strength and it took passion. We kept our heart in it and we sweat over it, and sweating again now just thinking about it. It's lovely, it's a bit spicy, it's luxuriously creamy, a little bit crunchy with the breadcrumbs. You can put these breadcrumbs on anything now that you know how to make them. Let your imagination run free like a wild stallion in the wild, wild west. Clint Eastwood, if you're watching, very, very big fan. Allora, amici, thank you so much for joining me today to make this wonderful, marvelous eggplant parmigiana, melanzane alla parmigiana. Next time, we're gonna see each other, we're gonna cook something amazing once again, and until then, take care of yourself. Ciao, ragazzi.